Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. Today I have a ginormous, super huge drugstore makeup haul for you guys. Oh my gosh. I went to Walmart for freaking eyeliner. I wanted one liquid liner and accidentally left with like $300 of makeup. So this is a huge drugstore haul. And honestly, I don't even think it's big enough to be $300. So like, drugstore makeup's getting a little pricey these days, isn't it? I don't know. I also wanted to grab some new brow products because I hate running through my expensive brow products so quickly. So I have a bunch of stuff here today that I purchased that I'm going to share with you guys. I also just did my face in all of the drugstore products. Well, not all of the products that I bought, but all the makeup that I have on my face today was from this haul. And I did film that tutorial. I do a lot of chatting in that video, so I didn't want to do a try on haul. It would have been super long. So I just filmed that tutorial. That will be up tomorrow, but I wanted to show you guys what I hauled first. And then tomorrow you can see me use it in my video. So without further ado, let's get started. I first want to start with foundation. So I grabbed a total of three foundations, but two are the same foundation, just two different shades. One that kind of matches my skin tone very closely, and then one that's for my self tanning. So that is the problem I'm running into recently. I've been buying makeup for my self tanner or just for my pale skin. And then I run out of self tanner foundation or I run out of normal skin foundation. And so I just decided to grab two. This is the L'Oreal Infallible Fresh Wear Foundation. Is this new? Because when I went into Walmart, I was like, what is that? I've never seen that before. So I could be behind on these. It's been a minute since I did a drugstore haul. But yeah, this is the Fresh Wear Foundation. It's up to 24 hours. It is long wear. It says it's breathable texture, which I was like, what is breathable texture? But I will say I have it on today. It is so comfortable. I actually can't even feel it. It's very thin, like liquidy thin. So I'm excited to keep using this. You guys will hear more of my thoughts on it in my tutorial tomorrow because I do have some more things to say about it. But yeah, I got it in the shade 445 and 430. So 430 is good for just like right now with no self tanner. 445 will be perfect when I do have self tanner. So I did get these two foundations. And then I also bought this one for a self tanning shade because it's currently that time in my life where like everyone Alok and I know are all getting married. We've gone to a wedding almost every single weekend over the past month. We have another wedding this weekend. So basically I just can never have enough self tanning foundation. This is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Glow in the shade 204 Natural Buff. I just know that I really like this foundation, so I wanted to grab one that I feel comfortable using. I like the coverage, and that's a little bit deeper to match my self tanner. So that's what I got this for, and I just love it. This has been like a favorite of mine for a long time. So yeah, L'Oreal, I just always love their foundations. I'm a little biased because I've worked for L'Oreal companies in the past, and I know personally from touring the labs and things like that how much work L'Oreal puts into their makeup and the research and the wear tests that they do on their own end. I always am like really loyal to L'Oreal foundation. Really love this one, just wanted to pick up another. Also in the face makeup family, I got the L'Oreal Infallible Full Wear Concealer. Is this new as well? I've never tried this before either. I'm really excited to be using this. I believe it's almost meant to be like a tarte-shaped tape dupe. It's got the really thick doe-foot applicator and everything. And yeah, I'm excited to be using this. I got it in the shade 340 Fawn, so it's actually a little light for me today, but I did really enjoy using this. I'm excited for you guys to see it in my video. Let me know if you've been using this because I think I'm gonna like it. Next, I wanted a more affordable baking powder. You guys, I'm just so sick of spending so much money on high-end makeup that because of my tutorials and because of all my filming and because of like my lives watching videos, I go through face makeup so quickly. I'm always redoing my foundation or redoing my under eye concealer after like every swatch. Like, you know what I'm saying. I run through face makeup like water. So I really wanted more drugstore options so I'm not losing so much money every month. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Translucent Setting Powder. I've never seen this before from Wet n Wild. I don't think it's new though. I think I've just never seen it before. I was like, is this gonna be okay for baking? Tried it today. It is wonderful for baking and I feel so happy to have an affordable baking powder. It just makes me so happy. I do love the Maybelline Fit Me Powder as well, but I noticed that one almost oxidizes when it hits my concealer. I have the translucent, but I do feel like it turns a little yellow. So I'm excited to use the Wet n Wild one. I love that it comes in a big old tub and it's just in the shade translucent. I recommend this if you're sick of buying the Laura Mercier's or the Too Faced or the Huda Beauty's. Don't get me wrong, I love those setting powders, but it's just nice to have one to not worry about running out of and needing to replace it. You know what I mean? Ugh. Some other face items I'm really excited about. So this is a new blush I saw from Neutrogena, and I don't like think of blush when I think of Neutrogena. They've not been my favorite makeup brand lately. I will say that when I first started wearing makeup, makeup like in middle school. I think probably one of my first few foundations was a Neutrogena one because my mom was like, all right, this is, go with Neutrogena. It's going to be better for your skin. So that was probably one of the first face makeups I tried. And then over the past few years, they've had some things I like, definitely, but it's not somewhere I always go to, you know? But I saw this. This is the Neutrogena Cheeky Wink Blush. And I was like, what? This is what it looks like. Isn't it so beautiful? This specific color is First Crush. And I looked at this and I was like, oh my God, that looks like the most romantic, beautiful little blush. So I thought this was actually going to be a powder blush, but it's actually kind of creamy. It's not like moist, tacky, jelly, glossy, creamy. It's like a drier cream. And I love that because I have more oily skin, but I love how long a cream blush wears. This is like right up my alley and I am super duper stoked about this. I want to go back and see if they have more shades. I do have it on today. I'll let you guys know more about it in the video tomorrow. I actually, like I said, I thought it was a powder blush, so I kind of hated it. And then I was like, oh wait, no, it's not a powder. I'm a dum-dum. So I'm just really excited by this blush. I pray that there are more in the world, more shades. It kind of has like a golden sheen to it too. I don't know if you can tell. It's gorgeous. Next, I don't think this is new at all. It says new, but you know how some things just say new for a long time, but they're in like the grocery store for like years. This is by Hard Candy. It's the Just Glow Baked Highlighting Trio in the shade Cruisin' the Coast. And like, look how pretty this is. This really excited me. I want to get back into Hard Candy, like in a really big way. I used to like, love Hard Candy. And then over the past few years, I haven't paid them much attention, but I really want to start paying them more attention because this is adorable. You get three really pretty little, oh, ow. Pinched myself. You get three really pretty highlighters. They're a little dry for sure. You're not getting absolute best quality, but you know, to save yourself some money, get a little bang for your buck. It's a nice little palette and it comes with that brush, which is adorable. I really want to see what other shades they have in this because I do really like it. I mean, look at this glow I have today. It's exciting. Let's jump to like eyeshadow palettes for a minute. I have a few eyeshadow palettes. So I saw these from Rimmel and I think I'm dumb because I might actually have these already, but when I was in the store, I couldn't remember if I had these specifically. So if I have unopened ones, I'm going to put them into a giveaway because I have a lot of giveaways coming out in May. These are the Rimmel London Magnifies Spiced Edition Palette and the Crimson Edition Palette. I mean, they're just so gorgeous. Obviously, the crimson one's very berry-ish and maroonish, and there's pink, and then the spiced is all warm tones, and I just thought they were so pretty for drugstore makeup. I do have some of the spiced one on today, along with another palette I'm going to show you in a minute, but the quality is just so good for drugstore. I am like over the moon about these palettes. I can't wait to use the pink one more. They just have me really excited. One thing I think Rimmel's really been doing great on is their eye makeup. I've been loving their palettes. I'm excited to use these more. They are just gorgeous. By the way, if you like my long pony I have on today, this is by the brand insert name here. You can look them up online. They have a website. They have an Instagram account. And they have extensions. They have wigs. They have long ponies. So this is their long pony in the shade black. And I love it. I'm feeling very Ariana Grande today. Very sassy. This is like a bow I have in here, but it just blends in because of my hair. So the other palette that I used today, which I am like beyond excited for, and I want to pick up the other shades of this palette. I thought I would try out one first and see how it actually like goes. And if it was okay, I would pick up others. And I'm so excited that I love it. This is the CoverGirl and Revolution eyeshadow palette. I think they have like four different ones. So when I was in store, I was like, wait a minute, CoverGirl like totally jacked Makeup Revolution's logo, like font and all. And then I realized it's like a collab and that is so freaking cool. So these palettes kind of look Game of Thronesy. I'm assuming that's what they're inspired by. I don't know. Does it say exactly what palette this one is? I can't see a name for this exact palette because like I said, I think there's four different ones, but I just got the red one and I do have it on my eyes today. I cannot wait for you guys to see this tutorial. It is so pretty. Look at this super unique, like a mustardy shade. You know, I'm crazy about that. There's a beautiful gold and kind of macaroni, burgundies, purples. There's a blue, there's a cream. There's this rusty kind of, you guys know I'm not good at my color descriptions. There's a rusty color. I mean, it is just gorgeous. I could not believe when I saw this palette in the drugstore and I could not believe how good it went on my eyes today. Like I said, I'm like beyond excited for you guys to watch my tutorial because it was just a dream to work with. Let me know if you have any of these CoverGirl and Revolution palettes. I'd love to know which one you recommend that I pick up next because like I said, I only bought the red and I think there's three other versions. They're just so cool. It's exciting to see this type of eyeshadow palette like in the drugstore. Like, look at that packaging. It is so cool. Okay, let's get into why I even went into Walmart in the first place. Well, first of all, I had to get cat litter. Actually, while I was there. But also, I wanted to grab a liquid eyeliner while I was there because I keep going through my high-end ones so quickly, like I said. So I asked you guys on Twitter what eyeliner you recommend. Everyone recommended Physicians Formula, and of course, Physicians Formula liquid eyeliner was like sold out. So it must be really popular, and now I can't stop thinking about it. I might place an Ulta order because like I just want to try it. Everyone was talking about it, and I don't think I've ever used it, so I really want to give that a go. But instead, I picked up the Milani Eye Tech liquid eyeliner. I did like this today. I will say that I felt like it was fading, so I ended up topping it with my e.l.f. cream black liner, which I also bought at Walmart because I could not decide. Don't you love a brand new pot of black liner before it's all dried out and weird? Oh, it's so nice. So anyway, I did use this liquid liner today and it was okay. I think because I have metallic eyeshadow on, it was having a hard time covering that up. So I did a layer of this and then a layer of the e.l.f. cream on top of it, and it was perfection. I'm still happy with my purchases, but I need to get that Physicians Formula liquid eyeliner that everyone was talking about. Like, what the heck? Why have I not tried that yet? It's insane. Okay, so this next thing, I'm not gonna tell you guys how I feel about it because it's a whole experience in this tutorial, but I have the NYX Fill and Fluff brow pencil. Have you seen this madness? This is madness. So it's a new brow pencil from NYX Cosmetics. Did I say e.l.f.? Why do I feel like I said e.l.f.? Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. Who knows? I have it in the shade Brunette. So it is a thicker brow pencil. It almost reminds me of like the Benefit one that's kind of angled, which I do enjoy. But the weirdest part is the brush at the end of this eyebrow pencil. I'm zooming in so you guys can see. It is actually like one of those weird painter's brushes, or what do they call that brush style? A lot of people use them on YouTube and on Instagram, but it's actually on a brow brush. It's just the weirdest thing I think I've ever seen in my life. This was an experience. It was a journey while I was using it. I'm really excited for you guys to see that in my video because I have so much to say about it. I did do my brows with it today and I think they look pretty great, but oh my gosh, I have a lot to say. So check back probably tomorrow for that tutorial because oh my goodness, it's crazy. So real quick, while we're talking brows and like eyes and things like that, I did get a refill of my Maybelline Total Temptation mascara. This is just like a go-to for me for the drugstore. I love it so very much. It's fantastic. I have it in waterproof, but I've been like getting sick of using waterproof mascara all the time. So I just wanted to get a regular formula. Loving that. I already knew that I do. Then I got the L'Oreal Unbelievabrow Longwear brow gel, and I've not tried this yet because I'm just really getting intrigued by all the new drugstore brow products that are coming out. And this one I really wanted to try because it reminded me of the new, and oh, this is the wrong shade altogether. This is Brunette, but this is like so light. I don't know, I'll have to give it a go. But it reminded me of the new Anastasia brow cream. Do I have that near me? No, I do not. I just hauled it. You guys just saw me use it. It's the new dip brow gel that you can use with an angled brush or you can use with a spoolie. Well, this is like the same thing. In fact, they give you a little angled brush with a spoolie on one end, and then I believe it comes on like a doe foot. Like, what in the hell is going on? This is so crazy. I don't believe it's anything new, but I'm confused, fam. I am like so freaking confused. So I am excited to try this out. I didn't today because I was really paranoid it was not going to work out, and I didn't want to have like a makeup fail video today. I really wanted to do a nice drugstore makeup tutorial. So I'm gonna do like a whole in-depth brow video I think soon, because I have even more brow products I didn't even show in this video that I think we should just talk about all together in case you're looking for a new brow routine or something like that. But I'm terrified. Have you guys used this? Let me know what you think. I am so scared. And then I also got the e.l.f. Lock Liner and Brow Cream in the shade Medium Brown. I think I told you guys this at my Sephora haul. I was thinking about getting back into ABH's Dip Brow, but I was like, let me just shop for a cheaper one before I do that. I do have the Sigma one, which I love. Mine's almost empty, so I could just get another one of that, but I just feel like exploring right now, and I don't remember how I liked the e.l.f. one. I know this is nothing new, and I know I've tried it in the past, but I don't remember how I liked it. You can also use it as eyeliner, which is kind of cool. So got that. And then I'm dumb because this must be the old packaging and this is the new packaging, because I bought two of the same thing except one is in espresso. So that might be nice because the medium brown might be a little too light for me anyway, so I might get a good little ombre brow, if you know what I mean. So there's one product I'm missing that I was filming with like an hour ago, so I don't know what the hell I did with it, but I did get a new lip treatment that you will see in my tutorial. Other than that, for lips, I got two new CoverGirl lipsticks. The one that I have on right now, I also have on with my favorite lip liner in the world. This is a Jordana's Rock and Rose lip liner. It is beautiful. And on top of that, I use the CoverGirl lipstick in the shade Streaker. I love CoverGirl lipsticks. I think they are just such a good go-to lipstick. They are creamy. They are pigmented. They have 1,000 colors. Not 1,000, but they literally probably have like 100. They have so many colors and you can just totally find what you're looking for almost all of the time. They are so nice. The other color I got is cream. And I think cream's a little more toasted than the previous one. Yeah, you can see it's just a little warmer in color. Oh no, it's called Tempting Toffee. I'm sorry. It's a cream formula. It's called Tempting Toffee. And that does describe it really well. So that's a cream. And then the one I have on right now is a demi matte, which I love. It still looks glossy, but it's not. So demi. I just love a good drugstore lipstick because I don't feel so guilty when I eventually and inevitably lose it because that's just what I do with my life. And they're super comfortable. They don't get drying. I love all the liquid lipsticks and the lip stains and the lippy pencils and things like that. But sometimes you just want a good old fashioned lipstick that you don't give a hoot if you lose it, if you break it, if you drop it. And you know, it's just gonna be comfortable and make your lips look pretty. Like, it's awesome. So I love CoverGirl lipsticks. I'm like crushing on CoverGirl right now. Interesting. Like I was saying earlier, I kind of like have always been a L'Oreal girl at heart, but right now I'm really crushing on CoverGirl. So that's cute. Oh my gosh, I bought so many pretty things. Okay, lashes. So first of all, the lashes I have on right now, aren't they gorgeous? I don't know if you can see them that well, but like I said, you'll see them in my tutorial. These are by Kiss Lashes. They're from their Lash Couture line. The fact that I can buy like fancy looking faux mink lashes at Walmart is like really exciting. So I got those because I'm just out of lashes completely, especially with all the weddings I keep attending. I also picked up some of the Ardell 3D faux mink lashes. This is in the style, is it just 3D faux mink? Oh, 857. Gosh, I can never find out anything. This is in the style 857. They're really long and really wispy. So I'm probably gonna save these for a more dramatic like eye makeup video or something like that. These ones I just love. Like, they're really subtle, but you just like, to the side, you get that pop of lash and it's like, oh yeah, those are nice. These will always be one of my favorite lashes. These are just the classic Ardell Wispies. I think a lot of us started out with these lashes. I love that they come in a 5-pack and they're just good for me to have on hand. Comfortable with them. I know how they look. It goes with anything, dramatic or even non-dramatic eyes. The band is very, very, very thin, which I love, and they are just good lashes. It's also something, again, unlike my Huda Beauty lashes say, I don't mind if I lose them, if I rip them, if I accidentally cut a pair too short, because they're not that expensive and there's 5 of them. It's amazing. Is there 6 or 5? There's 5. I can do math. These! Oh my gosh, again, I'm like just so excited by this new Kiss Lash Couture faux mink band. These are called Gala. I'm gonna save these for my next like trial run with my wedding makeup because I know I'm gonna want something wispy like this. Could this be my wedding lash? I don't know. We will see. But they look beautiful, don't they? They look so soft and fluttery. That's the type of lash you just, well, I don't think you want to put mascara on faux mink lashes anyway, but this is the type of lash that you would not put mascara on because they are so perfectly fluffy. Please let me know if you have any other fluffy lash recommendations for me because I'm looking for some really, really fluffy lashes. I love, like you can see the difference. I love my Ardell Wispies. They've been my basic go-to for a long time, but you see how they're more scattered. And then you see these type of lashes next to it where they're more fluffy and just va-va-voom. I want some more va-va-voom lashes. So let me know your recommendations, please, from any lash brand. I don't care. You let me know who. Something a little more fluffy than the wispies that I keep going on and on about. These are the Faux Mink Luxurious Lightweight Lashes by Ardell in the style 811. These come in a 4-pack, as you can clearly see, which I love. And I don't believe I've tried these. If I have, I know that I've loved them because there is an Ardell faux mink lash that I used once and I was obsessed and I can never remember the number ever again. I'm hoping it's these. Love that they came in a 4-pack and I just feel so good being set with lashes for like a month. Hopefully, if I reuse these pairs like I should be reusing them. Some days I just want a fresh pair, you know what I mean? Okay, this is not makeup related, but it is nail related, and I am so stoked for these, you guys. So all of you know, I do my own nails. It's super easy and it's super cheap. I order all my shit off Amazon. I have the best nail glue ever. My nails stay on, if not 2 weeks, close to it. I almost always reach the 2 week mark, and then I just take them off anyway to have a fresh pair. But I love doing my own nails at home. I can choose whatever nail color I want. I can make them as long as I want, as short as I want, as pointy as I want. It's just something relaxing that I love to do on myself. And I do have a video up if you guys wanted to know my fake nail routine. If you want to know what products I use, I did do this video a year or two ago, and it's like stayed the same. I use the same nail glue, I use the same nails, and I get everything on Amazon Prime, and it is fabulous. But I saw these again. Kiss is killing it. I'm gonna give Kiss a kiss. I'm so dumb. Look at these freaking nails. These are by Kiss. They're the Glam Fantasy Ultimate Illusion Nails, and oh my gosh, they're like duochrome magicness. Please look at those. Like, oh my gosh. I love that reflection. I love the duochrominess of it. I love the matte ones. I love the gold ones. These just excited my heart and soul so very much. I can't wait to use them. It says it comes with 28 nails, which is a lot of nails. So for these, they usually come with like some type of glue tape type of thing. I'm not going to use that stuff. Yeah, it's like glue stickers. It's like weird. I'm not going to use those. I'm just going to use my own nail glue already that I love. Oh, and it comes with extras and stuff like that. So I'm excited to do this manicure. I wish I could do it right now, but like I said, I'm going to a wedding this weekend and this would not go with my dress. But I'm so jazzed about these. I'm just going to glue them using my own nail glue right on my fingers, and I cannot wait to rock these. These look so beautiful. I want to go on Kiss's website and see if they have different styles I could order, because at my Walmart, they only had this style, which I love, but I know they have to have more. They have to have more exciting nails. This video went like way faster than I ever wanted it to. Meanwhile, you guys are probably at home and you're like, this has been taking forever. What is going on? So the very last things that I picked up is my shampoo and conditioner. This is by Maui Moisture. It's the shea butter one, of course. I like really try to believe that I'm not that vain or self-obsessed, but I will literally buy anything if it says shea butter. Like, it is mine. Oh, but it smells so good. I feel like I'm like on an island. So yeah, this is the Maui Moisture Heal and Hydrate Shea Butter Shampoo. I need the hydration. You guys know I'm always complaining about like staticky hair on Twitter. I'm always going nuts over it. So this is for dry and damaged hair. It softens, it quenches, it repairs. It has shea butter, coconut oil, and macadamia oil, and it is sulfate free and it's super affordable. Like I said, I buy this at Walmart. I do go through it really quickly, but I love that they're both creams. You know how the shampoo sometimes can be like a gel type? I feel like that just dries me out. So I love that their shampoo is actually a creamy shampoo. And I just love this stuff, you guys. It just smells so good. It's sulfate free and it's cheap. Like, oh, you just can't beat it. Oh, it smells like just island romance is how I would describe it. It is beautiful. So nice. That is it for my drugstore haul today, you guys. Let me know if you've tried anything I mentioned today. Don't forget to come back tomorrow for my drugstore makeup tutorial on this look using all these products. It's a really fun video. I do completely full face, which I haven't done a lot of lately. I do foundation, obviously, eyebrows, lashes, the whole shebang. I think you guys will really like that. So stay tuned for that tomorrow. And if you wanted to check out anything I shared with you guys today, I will of course link it down below for you. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!